Sorry about that, we're cut. Let's continue. The good thing is they are fighting amongst them. Okay, this is a problem. I have been excommunicated from the church. And this will cause rebellions. Okay. Now, Hungarians. Let's send these troops here. Let's help this area out. And build some more troops. Portugal, yeah, Portugal is again getting rebellions, and this part here, 80% chance, and it happened. Let's build more troops. Now let's see what's the status. So currently, yeah, they are at war with Hungarians and the Golden Horde. And if I strike a truce with the Hungarians and push against Egyptians, that could work. Work with the Golden Horde. That could probably be the smartest idea. A little bit of backstabbing. Cold backstabbing. Assault this castle. Okay, can we move these troops? Yes, we can. And now it's time to. Yeah, I'm gonna move some of them, but not all of them. Just a few so I can defend the areas under the rebellions. And I'm gonna use them later on to finish off the French. The Italians, I'm sorry. I can probably do it right now. Yeah, I have enough troops for that. Let's do it. Let's use those boats. Let's destroy our enemies. Yeah, okay, on the top. I want to move these guys. Let's send reinforcements here. There's a 0% chance of a rebellion. Let's use these guys. And then I can deal with the Hungarians if they attack me, and they will want to go for me because I am holding their provinces. No extra troops there, and I should probably build some here because it's barren. Let's merge in these armies together to make it look cleaner a bit. Sometimes it will let me merge them, but it depends on their rank. You cannot merge lower ranks with higher ranks. Hopefully that will be enough. Definitely need to get some troops in Scotland. Up here too. Good. And here. Need to work. Nope, wrong troops. Deal with this part here, and I know exactly how to. I'm gonna send out boats, one boat here and one boat here, so I do connect. And leave this boat here and move these. And we are again pushing. I want to delay the fight with the Egyptians as far as possible in game. I don't want to lose these ships after this much work, and I will definitely lose at least half of them when the fighting starts. I should definitely build some troops here. I'm just looking at the map, trying to figure where are the weak points, and at the moment it's looking good. Let's see what happens. Okay, the Hungarians did attack. I don't know if will that result in a war, because those were the rebels. Yeah, crusade my ass. They want to crusade against me, which is fine by me. I'm not scared. Let's see, can we deal with this nuisance? Okay, so far so good. The map is opening up. Do we have any more troops anywhere? We still have to build a shipyard here. Port. We got one here, so jumping is possible now. You have to build ports if you want to use your boats. And you can destroy ports, and then the enemies cannot attack you anymore if you are at war. Let's get some troops here. I am expecting an Egyptian invasion anytime now. What's our gold status? 5,000 per turn. I'm still not going to build more troops. I want to be in a comfort gold situation. And then I can start thinking about it. So yeah, this should be the last of the Italians. And where are the Hungarians? I'm not managing to find them on the map. Bye. I'm really not stressing about Tunisia. They can have it. I'm not planning to start a new war. Okay, here they are. And we are not at war with them, so that's fine. Really fine by me. And we have mercenaries here in Croatia. So we have one possible army if we need it right now. I'm gonna focus on building. Let's build. Let's use this comforting situation and build. Gonna focus on increasing my gold income. Because that's the main thing we need, more gold. Spearman shop, and I reckon after that we can build those troops I love. We shall see. Let's check it out. Of spearmen. Yeah, we need not a fortress, but a castle, and I think spearmaker to make those troops, and they're epic. Okay, I deviated from the main plan, and that is to build. Made a full turn, and we should start rotating and building more troops again. Let's use these shields. Nah, these ones are better. The price is good. Okay, in Ireland, let's build men-at-arms. That one will help out a lot. They are stronger than the Vikings. Okay, a little bit of royal knights. I don't particularly like royal knights because there are only 20 of them in one stack, and they are not that strong in my opinion, or I just didn't use them enough. Again, men at arms. And the fighting will commence soon. I will probably push in this area, and I'm gonna reach the Egyptians and then fight them at the very end. That is the plan. But I reckon something will happen meanwhile that will slow me down. It always does. It always does. And this is so boring. These troops are really nice, but they aren't the best ones in my opinion. You have to take in some factors and not you have to take all of the factors in and not just some factors like the price or the amount of troops, because the ones that I'm planning to build are really fast and are armored up, so you can increase their armor by building armor shops, and with that, with the increased armor and spears, they look good and they hit hard and they are fast, so they are the best combination in my opinion. And these are these ones are gonna be my main troops for finishing the game. And to build them, you need the spear maker, and you need, I reckon, this possible upgrades. Training. Feudal men at arms. Yeah, these are getting available when you build a sword maker. And I reckon a combination of this spear maker and a castle gets you these troops, but I'm not sure. I'm really not sure. I don't want to give you false information. In certain areas of the game, you have special troops, so you have to pay attention to that. There are epic troops you can build and crush with like 500 troops. You can crush armies of 2,000, 3,000 enemies if you find those troops. But for example, Constantinople has a really high gold income, good ships you can build here, and if I remember good, they have good armies too. This is the mainland you want to take, and if you start here like the Byzantines do, you are gonna have a fun time. You can expand wherever you want. There are free areas here, so Byzantines are really fun campaign to play and easy. But the Danes are challenging, as you can see. Okay, we rotated our troops and let the spending begin. Oh my god, in one turn we lost all of our gold. Damn it. I didn't expect that to happen. Even the end about all of those rebellions. As I said, something is going to happen and something will slow me down, and it did. Yes, it did happen. Well, okay, we're gonna manage. And you can't do a thing about it. You can't do a single thing about those rebellions. They will happen and you will have to fight through them and just waste tons of gold just suppressing them and staying on top. But this is gonna destabilize this whole area because I'm gonna run out of gold and troops which can protect this area. That sucks. But we have our ships standing ready. We have our troops. And we shall strike. I missed that. Yeah, we lost a boat here. But okay, we do have two boats here, so we can just transfer one and be ready for the next turn. Now, that's it for now. I reckon we should just deal with these rebellions and the Spanish as best we can. Yeah, we cannot jump from here because we don't have the boats. Everything is disconnected. Well, I will risk it. Let's see what happens. So many fights, so many rebellions. That was a close one. Lost half of my troops there. Looking good. We aren't losing any battles. And they are looking strong. But we are stronger. Good job. And this is an easy one. Yep. Bye bye. Okay, I get it. You don't like me. Holy shit. Blah, 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 blah. Done. Okay, we lost a ship there. I noticed it this time. We are moving our ships again, expanding the reach as much as we can. Okay, and you see, we unlocked this part of the map, and if we want to, we can jump there now. But we won't do it yet, since our rebellions are getting the best of me at the moment. But I have to fight them, and that's it. nothing else I can do. Troops are getting built. The recruitments. I don't know why am I stuttering so much today. So we are getting more and more troops. We are defending. We are building, increasing garrison sizes, and it should be good. I guess this is the expert mode. Being annoying as it should be. Okay, we lost this one. That's fine by me. As long as the rebellions stop. But I cannot push at the moment anywhere with these rebellions. Oh no. That's a huge blow. I counted 13 rebellions at that point. No, I didn't see this one. Damn. This is a huge blow for my army. Have to deal with this rebellion here. This will help. What's our income at the moment? 7,000. Yeah, rebellions are diminishing my troop count. At war. Yeah, only the Hungarians. I reckon they are planning to attack me soon. And these rebellions, they are just slowing me and stopping me in my tracks. Finally they made it. I will have to deal with them right now. But if I move some troops there, the rebellions are gonna happen again. And which province did I... Oh no, I lost one more. No rebellions this year. We had 13 last year and 0 this one. So unbalanced. Oh, Frenchies. Hi there. They are looking for trouble. Trouble, trouble, trouble. Let's assault this castle. And let's deal with this nuisance here. How shall we do it? Yeah, rebellions are about to happen there. This should be enough. And let's deal with the French. Probably use these troops. Oh yeah. Let's go insane on them. The boats are coming in handy. shipyard. But we can go from here. But we have to leave some troops. That's the income. It's really low. Yeah, this should be enough. And the rest of these are going top to fight. Like this. Now let's hope for the best. Good. Even better. Good. Whoa, this was a huge battle. Oh, we lost. Okay, I can take this. My king died. Two rebellions. Let's see what's the dealio with them. I didn't get... I didn't see where they are. We're gonna see in the next. Okay. Fine. Anywhere else? Okay, the French are looking powerful here. Can we get some help? Let's just see. 100% chance of a rebellion there. 15. They are stuck. They are not gonna move from there. And look at these guys, just chilling there, enjoying life, not attacking me. And I love those kind of enemies. That's how it should be. Just chilling, enjoying life. Oh, we don't have a boatyard here. Yep. Do we have one here? Nope. Shipyard. Let's build it and we're gonna jump from here. We don't have any here. Yeah, let's transfer all of our troops to this spot. The shipyard will be finished soon so we can move from there. Push to those French. Bring the battle to them. Oh, I can use these. Let's use them right now. Okay. I don't think this will be enough. The French proving to be good. At least at this part. Other armies were crappy. At one battle they lost 2,000 soldiers. That's quite good. Quite nice. I'm not gonna touch anything here. I'll just leave it like this. They have to defend everything here. What's gonna happen here? 0% chance. Yeah, we can definitely... No, let's leave them. Somebody has to defend this part. Yeah, so my main army is here. And I have to wait for the shipyard to be completed. I might as well move these troops. And I'm gonna leave these armies to protect me from the Hungarians, since they love to attack me when I least expect it. and they did so a few times. Now let's build some troops here. Yeah, years have passed and I have to do a new rotation of troops. Do I have to? Yeah, in some areas that got attacked. Okay. Let's end the year. Let's see what's gonna happen. I'm drinking coffee, by the way. That's the sound of my spoon moving. Okay. Good. Execute them all. I'm gonna take them out. I'm not gonna stop it. I'm gonna take them out. Because I need this area to keep on moving, and the Spanish have appeared in a worst possible moment. Why? Because I don't have enough troops. I have to muster up troops from the parts where I want to leave them to defend. But I have to stop that rebellion right now. And hope for the best. Okay, this part is unprotected. Let's move those troops there. And this part too is unprotected, but troops will appear soon. Let's move our boats. Okay, we have two boats here. Looking good, looking sharp. Let's route these Frenchies out. This I would have definitely missed, but I did pay attention. Okay, this is gonna be good. This should be good. We need some troops here. And here. Because we did move a lot of them to different areas. Okay. I have to pay attention to my gold situation. Fighting these meaningless battles is so annoying. Let's just all be friends, be silent and fall to my command, and let's conquer the world, and it's gonna be fun. Oh, a huge defeat there. Rebellions. Oh no. And I'm really not enjoying this part of the game. Just fighting meaningless battles over and over again. So frustrating. Now this is going to get a rebellion. That's our goal situation. 6,000. I should probably spam troops everywhere I can. Nothing else left to do. At this point, it's just spam. Let's hire some mercenaries since we can afford it. Anywhere else? Oh, a few parts. The good thing is the port will be completed soon. I'm just thinking how to get more troops down here and from where. Stupid battles. It's just annoying. Yeah, and they are just keep on coming, keep annoying me. Let's deal with this. That will probably cause another rebellion because I don't leave enough troops there. But one more turn and then we are gonna have those troops. And we can use them. So yeah. That's the idea. The boatyard will be finished. Oh, hello. Okay, the Spanish have been dealt with. Fine. And now I'm gonna take them out. I have had enough with these areas. And since I have my troops ready, everybody's going to die. Okay, I misclicked there. Which is not too bad, they can have it. I'm tired of defending Scotland. We didn't have any rebellions and we dealt with Hungarians, and currently we are not at war with anybody. And in the next part we are gonna engage one of these factions: Egyptians, horde of goldmongers, or we are gonna go for the, which are these? The Alcamons. We shall see. I don't have a particular idea, but gold wise we are looking epic. 20,000 per turn. We are swimming in gold, so we are close to the end. Thank you for watching and see you in the next part.